Let's see, that there we don't, that we don't. So let's have a quick scan around the station while we're waiting for 8:14. So I'm going to try to do this so we leave at 8:14 UK time, so we'll be about 9 hours behind schedule. But in the meantime, let's just have a quick look around Caernarfon. So I'm going to go to the castle first. Caernarfon Castle, this is where Prince Charles had his investiture as Prince of Wales, well before my time. But that is a bloody good representation of the castle, especially when you consider it's quite a long way from the station. And this is Caernarfon, so we're going to go zoom in to Caernarfon. Oh, and there's some more. I'm very impressed, very impressed. It looks like Caernarfon. It definitely has that look and feel to it. If I'm going to be critical, and I'm trying not to be critical, I am fairly certain there was a marina with boats at some point around here, which doesn't seem to be included. It doesn't really detract much, to be honest with you. But it's not there. But the station is the very modern Caernarfon station, and it is very modern looking. So we're going to now run up the old line. So let's have a look at the coaches. So we've got the Pullman First Class Glaslyn, very nice looking locomotive. Then we've got what I assume is a buffet car with some standard class coaches following it, all open plan. And then we've got some more traditional private compartments, first class again. And then we've got the Garratt. Absolutely lovely, really done a fantastic job on that, I'm sure you'll all agree. Class 143, number 143 of our Garratt. So look at this name badge. So this is the South African Railways number 143. Very good detail, I'm loving it, absolutely loving it. Then we've got the Welsh Highland logo on it. Very good. So we're going to just run down the line. We've got about 5 minutes before we're going to depart. So there's a fair signal, it's already set for us. Got a 10 mile an hour zone as we swing through here under this footbridge. And we're now going to carry on sweeping up here. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump ahead a bit. I've lost the line, there it is. Is that the line there? Yeah, so we're going to carry on sweeping round. Doesn't look like it's going to let me go any further. No, it doesn't want me to go any further at the moment. Probably because the assets haven't been loaded in yet for further afield. But they will, in good time, they will come along. We're going to sweep down here. We're going to depart in about 4 minutes. So if you're watching this live, feel free to say hi in the chat. This is the Ffestiniog Welsh Highland Railway. Phase one, I think, cost me about £5 or £6. And then I got this one discounted because I'd already had the first one. So all told, it's cost me less than 15 quid, put it this way, for both routes, which I'm really impressed with. When you look at the amount of work that's gone into it. Phase 2 has brought out a lot of improvements. So there's only actually 3 asset packs which you need to own. So the first one was settled to Carlisle Railway, which, to be honest with you, every single person who owns a train simulator should have that line, because it's just in every single download data, and it's a fantastic route on its own accord as well, so it's worth it. So I would definitely recommend that one. And then the other one, which I've completely forgot, the Falmouth branch, which I didn't own, but I purchased it today. And then obviously the European asset pack. So we're going over this river and we're nearly back at the station, I would hope. So yep, I'm coming back into Caernarfon. We're a long way away from Caernarfon, aren't we? There we go, we're back into Caernarfon on the seafront, and there's our train. So a couple of minutes left, we'll see if we can get to the closest station. So that's the ticket office, all locked up. The shunt, and then I'm not sure where the station car park is. I know it's not actually at the station in real life anyway, but let's just zoom out and see if we can find it. I think that might be the station car park there. So this is Caernarfon. Oh, there's a marina. I take it all back. I apologise. That was me getting confuzzled. There is a marina. It has been done. I was wrong. I apologise. It has been modelled. I was completely in the wrong location. I was remembered it with the boats parked outside the castle. Although it has been a long time since I've been to Caernarfon, I must admit. It has been probably about 5 or 6 years since I last went. So things may have changed. Alright, it's time to get into the cab virtually. So we're ready to depart now. I'm going to take it off pause and we are going to start loading the passengers, and we'll jump onto the external view. So there we go. Lots of passengers on this platform. They've done a really good job there. I don't think I've seen any download route that's got so many passengers on the platform as this one. Really nice touch. So to begin with, we're going to stick our head out the cab door as we're loading up. Now, when I tested it on this scenario, the coal and the water didn't seem to be changing as I was in there. I've tried other routes and other scenarios, and it does bring the coal and water down. So I will message the guys just to let them know that this route is not working. I'm sure they'll have a look and sort it out. We're on our way now. So I'm going to reduce the brakes and we're going to get on our way. So we've got to keep it below 5 miles an hour as we leave the station. That is our speed limit. So we're going to keep it, we're going to try to keep speed. It is actually rather hard because it's such a powerful locomotive. So we're on our way. Let's have a look. This is a first class sightseeing lounge. Look at that. Very, very impressive. Ooh, I'm losing speed. Let's gain some speed up again. So this is a timetable run. So I'm going to try to keep time. In the stream intro, I did put a list of approximate times to be arriving at stations. Miles information for people. So let's see how we get on. We'll keep those times. So Dinas is 2.5 miles, 15 minutes away. As we're heading on down the line. Alright, we can open up a little bit more. Let's go for the blow on. Keep the boiler pressure up for the climb. Looks a bit due. So I want to keep the boiler pressure as high as it can. We have got a 5 mile an hour zone coming up. Down nicely. Pour it down a little bit early, if I'm honest with you. I don't know how many people are going to get on this stream. I don't normally stream on a Tuesday night. So we'll see. The full line will be up on YouTube afterwards anyway. So I'm going to stick on YouTube. So I'm going to record the whole thing anyway. So I thought I might as well stick it on Twitch. See if I can get any more followers. Twitch distance is weaker at the 3 meetings I use at the moment. That's why I thought I'd put it on here. I've got to keep it really slow this section. 5 miles an hour. Just keep it absolutely low. Keep it at 5 miles an hour, this truck. It is so powerful, this locomotive. still born in 1988, but still not 1% of the time to go. These are the most sometimes the road, these helmets. Once we get into more scenic people, we will have a few different shots. At the moment, as we're climbing to dinners, it's not that interesting to be honest with you. It's all forest, woodland, lava. So you can see Snowdon in the distance. We're a long way off from that. But you've got to remember, this is basically a two-man creation. In their own time, they're not making any profit from it. All of them is going to the Welsh Highland Railway. And compared to some of the books we see on actual dovetail routes, I'm thinking Kiel to Lübeck, the little minor things like that on relief, I'm really not bothered about. It is still very, very well done. Really, really well done. The press stop, I'm not going to look like to pronounce that name. Not stopping, there's way too to do this. was for a long time the regional terminus for the Welsh Highland Railway from Caernarfon. That's why we've got that point. And I still think there are some trains that run just canal from us. The actual full line, it's not, I mean it's worth it, don't get me wrong, it is value for money, but it is a full day out. And it's not exactly cheap. And not everyone can justify 40, 50 quid for a family. Especially not fully crazy like trains. I mean, I'm a big train geek, we all know that. We'll bring it to a stop and we shall let some passengers on board. There we go, a nice busy platform. Let's give them some steam for the photos. There we go. Really busy platforms, but it is in real life. Well, pre-COVID obviously. COVID's changed everything for the worst. Really, really well done. And this is Dinners. It looks like Dinners. It feels like Dinners. It is Dinners. So that is Dinners completed. Just let everyone board. Next stop, Portmadog. Level crossing at 5 miles an hour on this line. That's where we're doing this yard. Should take about 20 minutes. Now, Warnford, there is a campsite there. And there is a pub, which brews its own proper beer. So it's a campsite with a brewery on site and a train station. Is that not the ultimate camping? It is for me, I'll tell you that. Ultimate campsite that. Pub, brewery, trains, camping. Right, we'll just jump over the railway bridge so we don't go through it. nothing with these. Say hi in the chat. Let me know what you think of the route. And let me know what you think of the day, more important. Castle. Yep. And we shall now load some passengers on board. I think I meant to take some water here as well. No, I'm alright. I should have really stopped under there so I could take water on. But not to worry. How do we get on with the passengers? So the first coach is on and the last coach is on. I could have actually stopped earlier than that, if I'm honest. I stopped a lot earlier than that. But we've got a green signal. So we're good to go as soon as we've loaded up. Pressure's building up nicely. In fact, I'm going to have to... let off some speed. Otherwise, the safety valve will push me. Pick me up. 76, 75, 76, I think. Right, next stop would be... Snowdon's on our left hand side. So that is Snowdon. I wonder if it was made. Snowdon Mountain Railway in 2008. I don't know if I'm for that. Someone is made it. Before. So that would be a challenge. The challenge for me is to make it back to England. Someone must have made that somewhere, missing there. I'm going to Google that while we're just heading out over there. Well, I can't see anything coming up. One from Microsoft Train Simulator. Which is a shame. So if any budding scenario makers are out there and they want a challenge, Snowdon Mountain Railway, please. Those people. I'll never go job on the railway, will I? Start of Snowdon. On the switch side today, I'm missing the speed limits. I'm all on the hood, but I try not to drive by the hood. I tried to die by speed limit. It took me a date on the exact middle of it, and I don't know if it was literally the first time I've done it ever before. I'll do a little practice on the downhill section between Ridge and Beth Garratt. don't know what station this is. Obviously, request stop. Pass you now. We're not stopping there, though. No room to get on. So I'll just have a little watch as it comes around the hill, through the road. If that doesn't get you moist, what will? 45 miles an hour. So this is Snowdon Ranger, Liverpool bus stop. Thank you. on this really tight twisty section. To the right you wish we could see more pepper. We should start getting a really good view of Snowdon now. Once we get past these trees, there we go, that's the start of Snowdon. I'm absolutely loving this route. long way from the road here as well. Signal, that's absolutely great. We've got a meet here, by the looks of it. Looks to be another train in the station ready for us. Future stop, and we'll load some passengers in about 90 seconds early, so we'll be sat here for a little while, I'd imagine, which gives us ample time to admire the views. Let's go up a bit. So Snowdon is over there, I think that's some of Snowdon. Little tarn. Ridu station. With the Sherpa buses. I'm trying to work out which one's Snowdon. I think that is Snowdon. I'd imagine that would be Snowdon. Trying to get my bearings. Absolutely, really, really well done. So let's zoom back in. Let's have a look at this other Garratt. And I'm assuming this is just a stationary train on the line. It's not actually timetabled. Have a look at the map. Oh no, that is the up train. So we're then going to come past, we've got this tight turny twisty section here, which I'm going to have to do going northbound once, because that is really really steep, into Beth Gellert. And once we're past Beth Gellert, we're through the Aberglaslin, through the tunnels, make sure we don't get any blowback, and then it's all flat into, that's Minford, so this must be, here we are, that's Boston Lodge, so here we are at the station, Portmadog, which is where we're heading for. Not sure what this platform, this line here is for. Must be an avoiding line. It is a siding of some sort, so it must be there for a permanent way use, I would imagine. So the bus to Blau now, Ffestiniog, Aviva. Correct, that's what I like to see. And here we are, in steep in Snowdonia. Isn't it spectacular? I just can't get over this route, I really can't. I am absolutely in love with it. So we're ready to depart very shortly. And then it's southbound to Beth Gellert. I'm actually going to leave the brakes on. I'm on the brakes at about 13. I've done that on purpose. Because it was a very steep decline. Thank you. Portmadog. Didn't have the brakes on, this would be an absolute nightmare. That's why I set the brakes here in the do. I've got the brakes where I want them. And I've all been down. 2.something% at the moment. So this is from spwellrails.co.uk. I've got nothing to do with the website other than being a customer. This guy has developed this route and along with a river route for a railway, the Tully Railway. But I have to say I'm very, very impressed. Put some full price DLC at the shame of the moment, would you? tiny brakes because I completely missed that 5 mile an hour rule. carriage cross trailer. Oh, my head's just come off. Just lost me out. Just gone through. I've just got permission to go through that in time. Right, that'll do us. Made an absolute pig there of that, not gonna lie. That was appalling. Here we are, we're all on the platform. The loading up, it was about 15 seconds late, I think. This is such a tough section really, isn't it, Rick? I have practiced this section, because I knew it was tough. I knew coming to Beth Garratt was tough. And when I practiced it, I did make a pig's ear of it like that. So the, over there is Moorhebog. That is Moorhebog there. Nice little walk. And over there behind us is Snowdon. Right. We are on our way. So I've got to turn the blowers off. Not on full, but not far off in this next section. If it is that slow and tight, I need the net. We're now heading to the Aberglass Inn. I have so many fond memories of Aberglass Inn. Absolutely loved it. I grew up as a child, before living in Beth Garratt, taking my trip there. It was absolutely magical. Me and my ex-wife and holiday there a lot as well. Very, very happy memories. Had a connection in Beth Garratt. Very, very fun memories of Beth Garratt. From childhood into adulthood. The first time I rode this train in real life, down there with Glasgow, was magical. Absolutely magical. Here. Keep it 5 miles an hour. It's actually 0.1 over 5 miles an hour. Has got me, got a tear to my eye, I'm not going to lie, I've got a tear in the eye over this section. train. Speed in there. We'll try a new one. I'm not sure it was ever actually a public footpath. We used to use a public footpath. I'm playing in the glass thing down there with the rocks. In summer, there's a bit of a beachy bit there. Really deep section, so you could dive into the river, paddle as well. We used to build dams across it. Every kid did, it was just magical. Proper childhood memories there. And this track bed we're on now used to be actually a footpath. So when they built the railway, they had to build a footpath along the glass loop. So that footpath wasn't here, that was just rocky outstrops, and we'd just walk along the railway track. So it flattens out now, so we can use the plates. Idle our way down. So we're a little bit late, so I am going to have to speed up this section for a little bit. And then just allow the train to slow down on its own. And we will actually apply some more brakes. We're going to bring the brake quite down to 13 inches pressure. Series of tunnels. ground here. I don't mind these with brakes because as soon as we leave this tunnel, just start going downhill again. Let's have a look. In the observation car at the end, in first class, all very posh. As we go through this tunnel, there's Aberglaslin. That is the last tunnel, so I'm going to put the blower on now. Get my pressure back up. Slow it down to 5 mph though. Running through the speed in through that station. Really low pressure now. So thankfully it was relatively flat. Control there and then top level. I am only about a minute late. I really need to get the key. On the section. not so seasonal, please. There we go. It's not doing very well in this section. move on. Let me touch it a little bit. I don't think I've got any big flames left. Fairly certain it's all flat and soft weather. But just in case it's not, let's get any pressure on it. Time wise, I'm about 8 seconds late. Done far too early. I've lost some more time because of it. Window. permission to pass that signal. Red light here, so I'm assuming I must be waiting for a service to come. Hello there. You've joined us just at the end. We've just got one more station to go, and then we're pulling to Portmadog. And on we go. I'm going to put the full stream on YouTube anyway, and I will be doing this again because I've made an absolute pig deal of it, if I'm honest with you. It's absolutely stunning, this route. Absolutely stunning. I don't know if you can rewind on trip, but if you can, go back to Aberglaslin and Riddu through the Snowdon Valley. It's absolutely amazing. This section here is a little bit flat. So over there you've got Noel Hebbog. And then we've got Snowdon in the background. Squeezing again. On the final 2 miles, that's taken me 2 hours or so far. slow it down because it's 10 mile an hour zone. Yeah, this is a rail driver, so they're very few and far between in the UK, but you can buy them in the US, and they come around every so often in the UK. I actually imported mine. They're not cheap, but it definitely adds to the immersion, and with some locomotives, it does actually make life a lot easier. Some of the German ones can be a bit of a pig to drive, especially when you've got 30 notches on some of the, I think it's BR218. And the 155 Deutsches Bahn locomotives with 30 notches, they can be a bit of a pain to drive if you're not using the rail driver, I find, but the rail driver just adds to the immersion completely. You can pick them up on eBay every now and again, but I mean, as I said, I bought mine in the US from the US and imported them. By the time I paid tax and postage on it, it basically doubled the price. But I definitely don't regret buying it. Just feel you've got more control with it. Saying that, I'm not doing really well controlling this one at the moment. Should be heading to Portmadog, I would imagine, any second now. Bit of street running. So that is the original Welsh Highland Railway, Portmadog, who started building the line. They didn't get very far with it, and they just didn't have the resources to finish the line, so the Ffestiniog took over. That is a main, well, I say main line, it's not a main line, but it's a British rail line to Coeli. From W Junction. That building there, that is the Portmadog Brewery, I believe. And past the car park. On the other side, you've got some lakes. down now to the 5 mile an hour level crossing, which possibly has to be one of the longest level crossings in the UK. So there's the harbour. Do we need some brake? I'll just give it a tad brake. There we go. So there we are, as I say, possibly the longest level crossing in the UK, this I would imagine. It's almost like it's actually a street tram at this section. If you've got Train Simulator, I would highly recommend this route. So it's two phases. So phase one's been out for a while, which is a Ffestiniog line. I think that's £7. And then if you get that one, this one's £6, the Welsh Highland one. I mean, you consider how much Train Simulator DLC normally costs. I think it's a bargain for it, to be honest with you. It's £15 tops, and all the money goes to the Ffestiniog Railway. It's not done for profit, it's done for love. And obviously, with COVID, it's really knocked their finances, so it's a really good way to give back to the railway. And inexpensive, and you get a fantastic route out of it, you really do. Absolutely stunning. It's just so well done. So we're going to bring it to a stop. And then we shall see how we got on. Just quickly load up. So, I mean, the station itself is just amazingly well done. The Portmadog station. It's just Portmadog station. It's just absolutely amazingly well done. Got the marina behind it. It's just absolutely stunning, and then obviously you've got the cob, and that's us done. So let's see how we did. So it's 45 speeding tickets, 3 spads, although I did actually tab through 2 of them. Must have missed one completely. And it took 2 hours 50 minutes. So we actually look at the timetable, I mean, this is what you get for £15. These are all your scenarios that you get. I mean, it's just absolutely fantastic. That's a really fun one to do. So you're literally riding a gravity train, sleigh train, and you're just on the brakes. I've done a video on that on YouTube. That's really, it's somewhat different, if that makes sense. And then I don't think there's any career ones. Be surprised if there was. No, there's no career ones, but locals wise, I mean, you get so many locals included in your money. Where would I be looking? Not there. Here we go. So you get Blanche. Many loads up. I have quite a few locals. So you get Blanche, David Lloyd George, the drivable slate wagon, Ellen Moniff, Linda, Meridian Emery's, Ffestiniog Mountaineer, Palmerston, Prince, Taliesin, Welsh Pony, the list just goes on. It's just a really, really well, and then obviously you get Taliesin and another Garratt there as well. So it's just really, really worth it for 15 quid. You just cannot complain. It's just amazing. I mean, you could charge twice what he does, I think, personally, for that route. It's so well worth it. So for that one, I mean, there's two, three. I mean, that's Ffestiniog. That is Ffestiniog. Ffestiniog. More Ffestiniog. Another Ffestiniog, more that's just quite fun. Then you've got all these here, and then you've got the Gaelic Explorer, although you do actually need to buy some more coaches for that one. That one won't actually load up yet until I've purchased some more coaches. Caernarfon to Beth Gellert. Then you've got the Glaslyn Ventura, Portmadog to Beth Gellert, another COVID one. That's the one we've just done, the uphill and downtail, Caernarfon to Portmadog, Riddu to Beth Gellert, and then Portmadog to Million for with some ash wagons. It's just, I just can't keep saying how wonderful it is. Anyway, I'm going to get off. Thanks for the chat. Feel free to give me a follow on YouTube, RedRev1917. If you're on Instagram, you can follow me there as well, RedRev1917. Post loads of screenshots on there of pictures of trains that I drive. So thanks for watching. Take care. Bye bye.